help friend. He's really a puppet, but he can turn his head. Look at the kids on the screen. And he blinks his eyes. What do you think about that? We're gonna make owl crafts. Pretty cool, huh? See if I can make his wing go. Yeah. All right, so we're gonna make a snowy owl, which I think you guys saw a picture of, out of a pumpkin, cotton, and a paper beak. And there's some really cool things about snowy owls. You guys might know them because this was Harry Potter's owl. Do you remember his name? Woohoo. Jenny Pope.
Hedwig.
Hedwig, that's exactly right. Hedwig was a big owl, probably like 4 pounds, almost the size of a cat. Some cool things about owls are they eat mostly lemmings because they live in Antarctica. And there are no trees up there, so they're not, these owls don't ever sit in trees. They just sit on the ground, which is really something we're not used to. And I'm going to see right now if I can play their sound for you. You can hear it. Let's see. Where are you? Okay, let's see. Okay. Oh, it's not gonna come across, okay. They have a really cool kind of dark kind of hoot sound. You can look it up on the internet and listen to it, it's pretty cool. So they live in the Antarctica and they eat lemmings and they don't live in trees. So that's the most interesting thing about them. Now the other interesting thing is about pine cones. Pine cones are always girls. They're no boy pine cones. And they have little seeds that are hidden inside the ends. And you'll come across sometimes they're nibbled away because this is a squirrel's favorite food. But you know who else loved to eat these? Dinosaurs. This was a, these have been around since the dinosaurs, and this was one of their favorite food, which I thought was really interesting. They keep the seeds safe, and some of them need fire to be able to pop their seeds out. And you know, less than 100 years ago, we had a lot more fires come through, and which they actually help the environment sometimes. It's not like the ones that are happening right now. But then the seeds would pop after a fire happened. The seeds would fall down the ground, and then they'd have a whole new empty space to grow into. That was a really good trick. There's sometimes, have you guys ever eaten pine nuts? Yes, my favorite food in the whole world. And those are actually from a particular kind of a pine cone. All right, so we're gonna start. I'm gonna use a little bit bigger pine cone. The ones that you have are on the smaller side, but my daughter brought them, sent them to me all the way from Colorado that she picked up in her yard. So yes, you got some bigger ones. All right. All right. So what we'll do is you first take your cotton and you just kind of stretch it out like this. And we're going to wrap it around this guy. And you take whatever I call these pokey tools. A pencil, it can be anything. You just kind of poke it into the little fins like that. So if you're actually looking at a real picture of one of these owls, they do kind of look like this. They have little stripes on them. And then we'll keep going. We'll take another one. And you'll keep wrapping around. Let's see. Wrap it around. And take a pencil or your pokey tool. Stick it down in there.
Do you want me to change it to your workspace?
Okay, that's a good idea. Okay, now that's what we're doing. Whenever we now find some empty areas, I'm going to stick some cotton in it. Poke it in there. Now, you may notice we don't see a lot of pine cones in this part of Austin. You can find them in Bastrop. As the kind of soil that we have here, we grow pines very well. So they're kind of hard to find sometimes. Okay, so every time just keep sticking some cotton in. Put it in. And wherever you have like a space right here, put some more in there. Like that. Everybody doing okay? Looking good. Look some more. Sometimes the snowy owls fish on the edge of icebergs. They just watch. The fish comes up, they grab it really fast with their claws. Pretty impressive. I'm gonna go all the way up to the top. These are good Christmas decorations too, or seasonal decorations, I should say. Can pretend there's snow outside. Okay. So here's my snowy owl. Sorry, right there. All right. So keep going. We'll do the beak and the eyes in a minute. I'll keep working too. Looks like. Sticking up there. And now I see a little hole down there. A little bit more there. Okay. Everybody about got one of them done? Pretty close? Yeah, good. See, hold yours. Everybody hold yours up so I can see. Ah, good. All right, almost there. Yay! All right, so those of you who are closer to the end, you can go back and you can finish, or you can go back and we'll put the beak on, and then you could actually go back and finish the white. So you got a black piece of paper in here, and I'm just cutting out a square. It's usually about an inch big. It doesn't really matter what size. Like that, okay? And then I'm gonna fold it in two to make a triangle. Okay. All right, then I'm gonna open it back up and I'm gonna cut it. It's just a quick, easy way to make a triangle. Just take a square and fold it in half. A little math there, a little geometry. All right, now with your triangle, you're gonna fold that again, and this is gonna make our beak. Okay? So what we'll do is we're gonna stick it on, it'll just kind of stick in and make its beak. Just kind of sits in there without even any glue. you go. My beak's kind of big. I could trim it down, but I actually kind of like it. I think it looks pretty funny that way. Okay, so next we'll take some glue. And I'm going to put glue on the back of my googly eye. It may take a while here. I see some owls dancing over there. Okay, so I put some glue on and I'm going to stick it right up above his beak. Now he's a one-eyed owl. So now we're going to add the second eye. Take some glue again. On. You can try a glue stick, but it doesn't really stick as well. I think it takes good old white glue to make this work. Okay. I'm gonna stick that on. His beak fell off, so I'm gonna stick that back on. On some of the pine cones, I had to glue the beaks on. They were just didn't sit in there quite right. So you could do that too. Just put some glue on the edges of it. All right. Woo woo! There's my owl. Oh, look, you got two owls there. Nice. Yeah, the pokes. Yeah. Anybody else got their owl ready? Oh, yeah. Oh, those are cute. Oh, they're so cute. Look at that. Oh, that's great. I heard, read the other day that kids in Sweden like to make cows out of their pine cones. They turn them on their side and put legs and ears on them. So here we are. Woohoo. Let's see here, Blake and Julia, are you guys owls done? Not yet, still working on it? Oh, good. Some good stuffing in there. And young Jew, I see you're still working on yours. Yeah. Let's see. They're still working on theirs. Woo-hoo. Okay. Make them sit. Your owl's watching you make your crafts. You did a good job. You have a question?
You guys can unmute yourselves if you want to ask a question or make a comment.
Do we cut it in half? What do we do?
So you make your square first. Yes, and you got two triangles. So then you'll take, let me make another one real quick.
You're never going to get accomplished nothing in
there. So you got your triangle like that. And you're just going to fold it again. And you'll end it up with kind of an open shape like that. And that just sticks in to your pine cone. You can kind of wedge it in pretty well. And if it doesn't wedge in, then you can put a little bit of glue. Show you on the ends. Just like that. And that'll stick in a little bit better. Give you a different nose here. There you go. Did that answer your question? My eye's slipping down. You do have to let these eyes dry a little bit. Oh, look, they look great. Oh, good job, Amelia. I'm trying to make them look right. There you go. Hello. All right, well, guys, have fun and finish up. If you haven't finished, young Young Ju, do you know what to do the rest of the way? She's being so careful. Okay, got it. All right. Well, bye, guys. Have fun and enjoy your owls. Bye-bye.
Thank you.